You know, PJ, we are here today because we're kind of celebrating your nuptials, your engagement, of course, and you can't have a marriage or a wedding without the proper send-off, the bachelor party. And from what I understand, you're having one heck of a shindig March 3rd at Southport Hall.
Yes, sir, I am. So my bachelor party is going to be WildKat Sports. We're going to be at Southport Hall. It's going to be a phenomenal show, you know. So I'm getting married in a couple months, you know, to my beautiful fiance. I've known her since middle school. Finally asked the question. She said yes, luckily. But I was like, you know what would go good with bachelor party? Wrestling, because that's my love, and I love wrestling, and why not celebrate it the best way I could? So we're coming down, all the Wildcat wrestlers. We got our heavyweight champion, Brady Pierce. We got Matt Lancey, Ryan Davison, the Wildcat tag team champions, Jace Spade and Buku down, Slime Season, Jace Valor. There's so many big stars coming. We have Katie Forbes, our only female graduate from Wildcat Sports. I mean, there's truly so many great talents coming out to our show, and I'm truly excited for that.
Well, you know, you talked about your love of wrestling, and of course, it runs in the family. Your father, of course, Luke Hawx, and the founder of Wildcat, you know, pro wrestling, and of course, the star of so many hit shows like Heels and Young Rock, and the list goes on and on. You mentioned that you love wrestling. Who do you love more? I mean, nobody's watching here, PJ. The fiance or pro wrestling?
Fiance, always, you know, but wrestling's a close second, you know, close second. But
good answer, by the way. Good answer.
Anyways, though, of course, you know, it's fun. Luckily, she's a wrestling fan. So, you know, when we met, you know, we started talking. And she's like, oh, I love wrestling. And she's come to the shows. We got a picture back from ninth grade where I'm holding her up at a Wildcat show, ironically. But I'll see if I can find it. Maybe I'll put it at the Bachelor Party show, make a little slideshow. But, you know, it's a great balance. And luckily, she's very understanding about what I do because, again, it's difficult. You have to travel a lot. You're going back and forth and all that kind of stuff. But I couldn't ask for a better fiance, honestly and truly. So, but like I said, you still got to have a good send-off, right? So that's why we're having the Bachelor Party show.
Absolutely. Listen, I was fortunate enough to be at the season debut, the return of Wildcat Pro Wrestling, earlier this year in January, I believe. And what a great show. And you had an excellent match against Jace Valor, I believe.
Yes, sir.
What can you say about that match, and do you like the outcome?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I've known Jace. So I've been training and wrestling 6 years in November. November makes 6 years of me being a pro wrestler. Jace started probably about a year and a half before I did. So, I mean, it's pretty wild because Jace is one of the people I trained with. And again, he's really been up and coming. You know, he's lost a lot of weight. He used to be a lot bigger and he's slimmed down. He's gotten so much more athletic. And honestly, he's definitely one of the best wrestlers coming out of Louisiana right now. And to be able to wrestle somebody like him on a return show, it was amazing. You know, we went back and forth and it was a true struggle. You know, I came out with the win, but again, it was tough, you know, like had it been a couple more minutes, I don't know if I would have won. So, but hats off to Jace for stepping up, and same thing for me for wrestling him. And again, I look forward to wrestling Jace whenever he wants.
And of course, you did it all on your own. You told your dad, who's also your tag team partner, Hawx Aries, and you told him, look, you're doing this on your own. You did. There was a few times there when Jace had you down. I was personally hoping you'd rake the back or scratch the eyes or something, but you didn't. You stayed good to your word, a true hero. Talk to me about how important it is to have your dad at ringside and to have spent so many of the past few years having him as a tag team partner.
I always tell anybody I talk to, it is a true blessing to be tagging with my dad. I mean, I remember, he's been wrestling as long as I've been alive, so almost 25 years next year. And I mean, he was my hero. I remember going to shows when I was little. I mean, there's a video of him when I'm 3 years old and he got thrown out the ring and I'm going to him and my mom just snatches me and pulls me back. And anytime he'd get hurt or lose after the match, I'd be crying. He'd come pick me up and put me on his shoulders and he'd tell me he's okay and stuff like that. So that's just my earliest memories of that. You know, we travel all along the roads to Georgia, California together. And once I started, you know, the first thing he told me is, hey, you got to finish high school before you start wrestling. I did that. I was about a year in. He's like, all right, let's start tagging. We did. And again, it's just so much fun. You know, we go everywhere together. We get to roam, we get to drive, we get to wrestle and be in the ring. And not only is he my dad, but he's also a coach too. So, you know, I'm in the ring and he's telling me like, hey, do this, do that. And he's not afraid to sugarcoat it. You know, he's very honest with me and I appreciate that because, you know, a lot of people can't be honest with people sometimes, you know, but he always makes sure to set me straight. But he's also a supporting figure too. You know, if I ever need advice, he's there to talk to me. And again, he's very busy right now with Hollywood. So right now he's taking a step back from wrestling and I'm stepping up. But again, he's still always there for me in my corner, and I appreciate that because, again, like I said, he's been wrestling almost 25 years now, and he's done a lot, man. So it's really a blessing to have him in my corner.
You know, you talked about finishing high school, and of course, you just graduated from UNO, the first on your father's side to do so. And of course, I understand that you've got just a little bit of the acting bug now, too, though.
Yeah.
A little stunt work, a little Hollywood yourself. Talk to us a little bit about that and that transition and what you've learned from Dad.
So I started stunt work about 2018. So it was about my sophomore year of college. And I did a film called Semper Fi. Nat Wolf was the main star, and Jeff Galpin was the coordinator for that. But I was a thug, I guess you could say, or a college thug. I was in the bar messing with him, and he got in a fight. He punched me, and I fell and hit my head in the toilet, you know. And it was kind of from there. It comes from pro wrestling. It's a lot of bumping, at least for my expertise for stunt work. It's a lot of bumping, a lot of getting thrown, a lot of body position and just coordination. And that film was, you know, no different. You know, I had to take a fall, hit a mark, and then, you know, afterwards fall down, stay dead, you know, sell, do all those kind of things. And again, stunt work's been a lot of fun. I've done about over 15, 20 films and television shows so far. My most notable one is Heels. It's on Stars, but it's about a small town in Georgia. Stephen Amell is the main star along with Alexander Ludwig, but it's about a family in Georgia that wrestle, and I play the referee. My name's Denny in the show. But in that show, besides reffing, you know, I have a few lines. Again, I'm talking to Stephen, I'm talking to Alex, and I'm talking to the actors. And again, it's a lot of fun. It's a whole different world, but it's very similar to professional wrestling in terms of acting, both acting and stunts, and I really enjoy it.
Well, what makes you think the transition from pro wrestling to acting such a smooth one? For guys, you know, obviously you think of The Rock.
Yeah.
You know, you think of Dave Bautista now.
Yeah.
I mean, look what he's doing. I think he's in a new M. Night Shyamalan movie right now.
Yeah, yeah.
Of course, Guardians of the Galaxy, and the list goes on. Mm-hmm. And of course, your dad and Young Rock and yourself moving into it. Why is that transition such seamless?
I think it's because pro wrestling, at the end of the day, we are showmen. As much as we are very athletic and, you know, we have to be very physical, we are showmen. We have to come out, we have to entertain the crowd, we have to talk to a live crowd, a live audience, you know, be natural. There's a lot of aspects of, you know, acting, you know, and I would say it's kind of more similar to theater than, you know, it is like TV acting, because in theater, it's the show must go on. If something happens, you know, I trip and fall, I got to keep going. And it's kind of the same thing in pro wrestling. Let's say somehow I slipped off the top ropes. Well, you know, I got to keep going. So, and it's very similar mentality, you know. And I think because we're such showmen, it translates a lot easier to film and stunt work.
And of course, you're quite known for one of the riskiest moves. It went completely viral all over the world, jumping off the Esplanade Mall onto the mat during a match. Talk to me about your decision to do that. Were you scared? Did you get hurt? And of course, you know, for those watching at home, don't try that.
Do not try this at home.
And did your dad, did Luke know that you were about to do this?
Oh, yeah. So I don't know if you've seen any clips from Luke from the old days, but my dad used to do like 450 splashes off, you know, 20-foot balconies onto thumbtacks through tables. You know what I mean? My dad was wild. And I never really aspired to be as crazy as my dad, but I'm like, I got to do a little something for myself. So we were at the Esplanade Mall, and I'm like, hey, I think I can make this jump. I know I can make this jump. I looked at it. I'm like, here we go. Was I scared? I tell everybody. Everybody's like, what? I was never nervous. As soon as I got up there, the one thing I had to make sure I did was get my footing. But as soon as I jumped, made the sign of the cross, I jumped. I knew I had it. I jumped like, oh yeah, I got this. I landed. My ribs don't get me wrong, it hurt. My ribs were hurting really bad after that. I was like, was it worth it? But afterwards, it just blew up, you know? It led to so many opportunities for myself, WildKat Sports. And, you know, would I do it again? No. Should anybody try it? No. But am I glad I did it? Yes, I am.
Were you surprised that it went so viral?
A little bit, yeah, but then I remembered we're in Esplanade Mall, and
right there in Kenner, Louisiana,
and I'm just, we're in a wrestling show, and we're jumping off, and it just made sense, you know what I mean? It was just crazy, but as big as it did, I don't know, I mean, again, it was on ESPN, it was on SportsCenter, ridiculousness, again, it's every year, for some reason, it just keeps going viral on Twitter, people keep reposting, so it's a blessing, because all it does is just provide, you know, more eyes on us, WildKat Sports, and I can't ask for anything more than that.
You know, we talked about, you know, Esplanade Mall in Kenner. You're going to high school, graduating from UNO. You're a Grace King product. You wrestled on the mat, you know, scholastically. Listen, is there ever, obviously you're doing all the right things, but do you ever want to take shortcuts in the ring? You ever want to just tell the crowd how you really feel?
Well, I like...
Because your dad was a good bad guy.
Yeah.
I mean, come on.
Yeah. I like to try to be... My motto in life is always treat people how you want to be treated, right? So always be respectful, always be nice, try to be considerate, because again, anybody can be having a bad day, and just because that doesn't mean, you know, they're necessarily a bad person or anything like that. So again, I always try to take the high road. That's how my dad raised me. That's how my mom raised me, my family, you know. And I mean, who knows? Maybe one day I'll get fed up with life. You know, they say the older you get, the more, the less you can put up with. But right now, I'm still pretty level-headed, and I think I'll keep being try to be an upstanding citizen.
Well, are you going to be an upstanding citizen come March 3rd?
Oh, 100%. I mean, come on. You know, I got to behave, man. So you know, nothing crazy. I'm actually wrestling Willie Mack, and Willie Mack has been wrestling for a very long time. He's wrestled for very noticeable promotions, one of the ones being Impact Wrestling. But he actually grew up, it's funny, because I've wrestled before in a tag team match with my dad, but he told me stories about him watching my dad when he was a teenager in California. He'd be like, oh man, I used to see Luke all the time when I go to the XPW shows and promotion my dad wrestled. So it's really cool because it comes full circle. And actually, with a lot of the wrestlers that wrestle, you know, they always tell me, oh, I've known you since you were this high, 3 years old and stuff like that. So it's very cool to be able to get in the ring with these guys. Legends are people that I looked up to or have known for a long time, and be able to test myself, because that's kind of where I am in my career phase. You know, I'm still learning, but at the same time, I'm very confident in my abilities, and I want to prove to everybody why I'm so good, why I am PJ Hawx. And I'm not just Luke's son. Again, I am a great wrestler, and I think that's what I plan to do for these next upcoming years.
And how much does your amateur background play into your professional wrestling career? Again, we talked about Grace King, what you did here in the state of Louisiana. And, of course, you're surrounded in a bit of a hotbed. Archbishop Shaw has a great wrestling mm-hmm. school. Jesuit has mm-hmm. a great school for, you know. What makes the wrestling here so good, and how much of it do you still utilize?
I think it's very important. Like I said, a lot of what I've done in the ring or do in the ring is because of my amateur background. So again, the way I lock up, the way I move, certain positions where I can just, again, I can pass somebody, you know, pass their elbow, and I can just shoot down because I've wrestled. You know, I know those movements compared to people that haven't. And also just my strength overall too. I may not be as big as these guys are, but my raw strength is there because, again, at practice, I was picking people up and lifting them across the Grace King Gymnasium, which, I mean, if you've ever been there, it's pretty long. So just doing stuff like that, picking up people that are heavier than me, practicing, setting them. We do that a lot in amateur wrestling. So I feel like overall that's added to me because, again, I learned the technique, how much grit it takes to be able to do those things, and just, again, my strength overall. But, again, I think it's very important. I mean, for us, Grace King was a public school system, so... I still go back and help coach every now and then. Actually, right now we're doing a summer program, Jefferson Wrestling Club, and we just had our first practice on Tuesday. I went back to help coach, but I think it's very important because, again, to be able to give kids that, you know, sports might be all they have, you know, besides school, and it helps them, you know, just have another outlet to be creative or to have fun or to not worry about things at home. And again, for me, it's very important to be able to provide those things because I had a lot of alum that came back and they helped support us, and to be able to do the same thing and help provide opportunities. And again, it's not just about wrestling or winning championships. It's about helping them become better people overall. And I think that's one of my main goals. I love coaching. At WildKat Sports, I help coach, and at Grace King, I love coaching. And it's, again, to be able to build the next generation is very important.
And how and who can get involved in Jefferson Wrestling Club?
So as long as you're still in high school, middle school, elementary school, it doesn't matter. But we will have some more information, sign-up information coming up soon. But all you need is a USA Wrestling Club card. So you can go on to usawrestling.com and then put in Jefferson Wrestling Club. Pay the membership there, and then come into Grace King. We have practice Tuesdays and Thursdays from 4 to 5:30. Could change, but that's what we're going for right now until school is done. Then we'll be doing more summer practices.
Fantastic. Well, listen, mm-hmm. I know that the Wildcat season premiere was packed, full house at John Curtis Christian School. This Friday night is going to be a little different. Going to be a packed house,
yeah.
But it's going to be a little bit more hardcore. It's adults only. It is a bachelor's
yes.
party. Talk us into the house.
This Friday, WildKat Sports, doors open at 7 p.m., and then show starts for 8. My Bachelor Party, we're going crazy. There's drinks, there's fun, there's hard-hitting wrestling, and of course, the man of honor, myself. Hope to see you there.
Fantastic, PJ. Thank you so much and congratulations.
Thank you
so
much,
Come back and see us again.
Yes, sir. Always a pleasure. Thank you.
And we'll see you Friday night.
Oh, yeah. We'll be there. Here we go. Let's go. We're ready.